diminished relationship with brands, where moms are just going out there and writing reviews on products and slapping them up on their blogs and hoping that someone comes to read them. There's an evolution where younger millennials who started makeup videos when they're 15 now have a million followers on YouTube, and the brand, and now their parents, and they're reviewing products on their blogs and on their vlogs on YouTube, and those are the relationships that brands are moving to. So how can you take part in that evolution when it comes to products? Number one, you gotta stand for something. It's impossible to be everything to everyone. So, have you ever been to a blog and you just can't figure out what the heck they blog about? I mean, have you ever been to a blog? So often a company will say to me, Maria, by 6 o'clock tonight, I need 8 bloggers and here's the opportunity and they have to blog about XYZ. And I'll go out and I'll look at some blogs and I'm like, oh my God, we got a little nutrition here, we got a little Disney here, well, we got a lot of Disney here because we got dreams of going to Disney, and we got a lot of recipes there, we got a lot of, and like, there's no cohesiveness, there's no story, there's no beauty in the way that they're talking about products. And so you really kind of wonder, well, where are their relationships and how are they speaking? So, and then even their recipes are dinner tonight with insert brand resample that they got last week. So pick something and stand for it. Stand for the story that you're going to tell, which goes into number two. Tell a story that resonates with your followers. Nothing yells sponsored post more than a non-authentic, straight-up review. This is the bag of chips. Here's the nutritional label. I'm going to take whatever was on this press release and regurgitate it. And guess what? 50 other people just regurgitated the exact same thing on their blog. So figure out the way you want to tell a story. And you know, it can be as simple as the way you use a product. A few years ago, I got invited to, I shouldn't say the name, but I'll give you a hint. I got invited to a maker of little rubber containers that have lids on them, okay? And I went into a room full of men, actually, and they wanted to know how to market to moms. And I went in and I had crayons in one, I had Legos in another one, I had sewing stuff in another, I had yarn in another. The last thing I had was leftovers for my husband, okay? So I go through my whole presentation and the guys all look at me and they go, that's really cool. And yeah, we've heard that moms put crayons in our containers, but we make containers for leftovers for husbands. And I'm like, okay, well then you don't want to market to moms. So you're the way you tell the story might just be the unusual ways that you have found, or the unusual solutions that you have found to a very traditional product. That might be your niche. But whatever it is, pick it and tell your story. Figure out what your story is and be consistent in the way you tell your story. Okay, number three, don't hide behind your words. Gotta tell you, if you are a new mom out there and you're thinking that after you have your baby, you're gonna start a blog and you're gonna do like Ashley and some of these other, Jessica, have done with their blogs, don't do it. I'm telling you right now, don't do it. Put your face in front of a video camera, because that's where the future of the blogging, social media, influencer industry is. I just made reference to the younger millennials who have been in front of a camera since they were 15 years old. If the only thing you do is launch a blog, you will not be successful in social media these days. I can't even tell you, it's been over a year since a company has called me and said, I want someone who will write a blog post. What they want is somebody that's good at telling a story and somebody that has an integrated platform across multiple medias. In fact, just yesterday someone said, I just want people who are on YouTube. So think about how you're gonna tell your story, and don't hide behind words. Put your face out there, because your passion will come out in your face, and quite honestly, brands want that face behind the name of blog. So what do you blog about when it comes to products? So go home tonight and write down 10 products that you absolutely cannot live without. Maybe Motherhood would be one of them. But think about 10 products that you absolutely cannot live without. Okay, so everybody knows that follows me what my number one product is that I cannot live without. Come on, who knows me that can tell everybody what my product is? Popcorn. I cannot live without popcorn.
Every airport.
Rich would know, but I cannot live without popcorn. Jessica, yeah. I eat popcorn every single day of my life, okay? If I don't make a U-turn into a Target for lunch or grab a bag somewhere, I have 19 popcorn poppers in my office, okay? No lie, 19 different popcorn poppers. I love popcorn. So popcorn is my passion. In fact, last week I just bought the URL ilovepopcorn.com. And I don't know what I'm doing with it yet, but I guarantee you I'm doing something with it. So anyways, write down the 10 things that you cannot live without, the 10 brands, the 10 items, whatever it is. And then look at that list, and those should be the people that you target to work with, because you're going to be passionate about their products, and it's going to come through to your audience, and it's going to come through to that brand. So currently, right now, if you follow me on Twitter, I decided to take my own advice because one of my employees asked me recently, who do you want to work with that we haven't worked for yet? And I'm like, I made my little 10 little lists. Well, I'm on Delta Airlines almost every day of my life. And I'm like, why don't I work for Delta Airlines? I'm always tweeting about them. So every single time I get on an airplane now, I take a picture out the window. Delta Airlines will soon, I'll get their attention because it's authentic. I'm on there every day. And I will get their attention because they know I genuinely love them. I'm a 2 million miler. I'm their biggest fan. I use them every day. And it's authentic. So eventually, I will develop the right relationship with them to be able to work with them. So make sure that you use their hashtag and pick those things that you really, really, because that's what's going to set you apart, which is my next tip. Stand apart from others. If you're going to start a blog after you have your baby or you're already blogging now, make sure that you're creative, because what's going to happen is 100 bloggers are all going to be going to the same brands, and if you can't set yourself apart, then your message gets lost to the other 99 that they already have. And don't forget your offline experience, because your offline experiences will set you apart. So, are you a mom who does a segment on a local TV show? Do you organize meetups with other moms? Are you a mommy and me instructor? Are you a doula? All of those things give you access to other moms that most bloggers don't have. So make sure that you're creative and you set yourself apart. So that's the product savvy that I wanted to talk about. But I also promised